Do you think that more people is in support of Afrika Bambaataa or not? And do you think that they're hiding behind the fact of social media?
You know, just responding to your questions now may make things even bigger than what it is. You know what I'm saying? Because it's all just a scheme to assassinate the brother's character. You want to assassinate the Amirage character. You know, for years, it's been like that. Hot 97, you know. All of these radio program directors, they want to assassinate the brother's character. They want to assassinate the brother's character, man, because of what he stands for. You know what I'm saying? You know, not because of something that he's actually done. You know, like, you know, Starnbuck Wild and anybody else that was, you know, aware. And we can prove that you was aware of certain things based on just the accusation. You know, you was aware of it. Why would you air it on radio opposed to going to your local police department? You know what I'm saying? Why wouldn't you call a city official? Why wouldn't you contact someone who could do something for this individual who's actually a victim? So you say. So the accusation reads that he's a victim. And what do? You take it and you expose it on radio, on social media. That goes to show you that from the gate that it's a position, you know, a hunger to assassinate the character of one of the most influential figures on the planet today. You understand what I'm saying? So very humbly, I would suggest that people, you know, begin to be more independent in how we accept certain things. You know, like, you know, you posting things and you shifting things and you passing on a word that this could be a possibility, but where is your loyalty to yourself? Where is your loyalty to yourself? You don't have to have loyalty to Afrika Bambaataa because many of you don't know him, but you allowing a personal situation to assassinate his public character, his public interest. You follow what I'm saying? So it's really not that all, you know, that deep. This thing has been going on for many years to other artists, to other, you know, public figures. And we as a people just allow it, man. We just allow it. So I always had an issue with, you know, standing up and representing certain things because people just wait and wait and wait and sit around for your downfall. It's not so much of what you put out. You know, you could be very influential, but at the same time, you know, you got people waiting for your downfall. So anybody who made a post, you know, about it, these accusations, you part of the problem when you share and continue the cycle of the filth without ever saying a word. You know, where's the balance been in that? And you pretend to be so heavy and so deep. You know what I'm saying? You pretend to be so conscious, so alert and so alive. You know what I mean? But what do you stand up for? How many people are going to be allowed to come and, you know, attack our soldiers, our family, our tribes, our public figures, man? You know, this is somebody who travels the world in representation of not just music, but a culture. So when you have somebody attacking this individual in the public eye, you're not attacking his person. You're trying to attack the culture, man. You're attacking the culture, and that means you're trying to attack the people of the culture. So a lot of you people who consider yourselves to be positive and conscious, yo, these fools are attacking you too. They're not just attacking Bam, they're attacking you. Because if they take away, you know, your inspiration, then what do you have, man? Them. You have them to look to. So they want to take whatever we give them. So we've got to stop giving them our soldiers and giving them our women and giving them our children. Giving up so easy, not even putting up a fight. I mean, we put everything up under a microscope. But when it comes to standing up for our people, niggas are scared of revolution.